Good morning. Wage subsidies are on the way from the federal government in a fresh initiative to help businesses and the economy survive coronavirus. Straight now to political reporter Jonathan Kersley. Jonathan, what can we expect?
Well, the Prime Minister and Treasurer are set to unveil a monster package. This will be wage subsidies paid directly to businesses, but whether or not it will be backdated to include those companies which have already laid off tens of thousands of staff remains to be seen. We are expecting more details shortly, but as businesses across the country close and jobs go, there's been an added concern foreign investors could jump at an opportunity to buy up interests in Australian companies. The government has moved overnight to ease that concern. All foreign investments will now be subject to review rather than just those valued at $1.2 billion or more. Meanwhile, work is ongoing on another vital support package to support renters who've lost their jobs. Tenants will no longer be allowed to be evicted from their home if they cannot pay their rent because they've lost their jobs due to coronavirus. This is an extraordinary move by state governments, effectively a six-month moratorium to help keep roofs over people's heads. But this will have a massive flow-on effect for landlords, for banks. It will be a very, very expensive exercise. So there's also tough new restrictions on our movements announced last night. Effective from midnight tonight, gatherings will be restricted to just two people. Families and other types of households are excluded from that. We are being urged to stay at home, only venture out for shopping when we need it, for medical appointments and to exercise as well. The over 70s are now being told they need to self-isolate right away. Stay inside. Do not go out. That is aged 60 if you have a pre-existing health problem. And the Prime Minister says buckle up because this will last for at least 6 months. The Treasurer, Josh Frydenberg, was on the Today Show a little earlier. Here's what he had to say.
We want to keep the employer and the employee formally connected because we know there's going to be the other side to the coronavirus, and we want businesses to bounce back stronger than ever. So by having people still connected to their employer, that will help that recovery phase.
That recovery phase, though, Mark, is a very, very long way off. And there are further changes too. This time to make it easier to get more hand sanitizer onto shelves more quickly. There's been concerns it's been running out in supermarkets and people swiping it from hospitals as well. No longer will manufacturers need to have their recipe approved by the Therapeutic Goods Administration. So long as it meets guidelines from the World Health Organization, it will be fine. This means a boost too for fire-affected winemakers because the key ingredient for hand sanitizer is, well, alcohol. And it's being made at those smoke-damaged vineyards as an alternate form of income. Vital at a time, Mark, when so many jobs are being slashed.
Indeed. Jonathan Kersley in Canberra, thank you. Well, stay at home. That's the simple message from Victoria's Premier to slow the spread through the state. After cases jumped by 56, we've got more now from Stephanie Anderson.
Well, Premier Daniel Andrews has laid down the law, confirming Victoria will move to tough stage three restrictions, meaning those gathering in groups larger than two people will face big fines. The Prime Minister detailed the measures as advice to the entire nation last night, but the Victorian government has opted to make the rules enforceable. They don't include those you live with or those working or studying. Daniel Andrews keen to make it clear that what may sound complex should actually be very simple.
There are many complex things in the world. This is not one of them. Stay at home.
Police have been given the power to hand out on-the-spot fines for those not following the rules. It's more than $1,600 for individuals and close to $10,000 for businesses.
Hopefully no fines need to be issued, but police won't hesitate to do that. And the fine is a very significant one, more than $1,600 on the spot. No questions asked. This is just going to happen. They're not mucking about because this is very, very serious.
Victorians are being told there's only four reasons to leave their homes: to buy food or supplies, medical care and appointments, going to exercise either in pairs or with only those you live with, and if you're heading to work or study that can't be done at home. In all scenarios, social distancing must be in place.
Stay at home. Follow the rules, keep your distance, wash your hands, cough into the crook of your arm. Just use common sense and some common decency. Do the right thing or people will die.
It comes as 56 new infections were confirmed across the state in the past 24 hours, bringing our total to 821. 29 people are in hospital. Four of them are being treated in intensive care.
We're still looking at a 10% increase per day nationally. If we're not doing the right thing, that increase could be 25, 30% per day. That will lead to 100,000 cases in a few weeks' time.
The new rules will take effect from midnight tonight, with all police officers empowered to enforce them and hand out fines. Anyone who spots someone doing the wrong thing is also being encouraged to alert authorities.
To Queensland now, where cases of COVID-19 have soared to 656, with three deaths recorded, including a 75-year-old woman who was a passenger on the Ruby Princess cruise ship. Police are now issuing on-the-spot fines of more than $1,300 to each person caught breaching new strict coronavirus restrictions. Work is also underway to convert Brisbane's R&A showgrounds into a makeshift hospital in case of a further spread. Well, thousands of Australian travellers will today arrive home and head straight into 2 weeks of hotel quarantine. Elizabeth Bryan is at Sydney Airport. Lizzie, how are the passengers finding the new restrictions?
Good morning, Mark. Well, there's been expected around 1,000 international arrivals here at Sydney Airport today, joining those 1,200 that touched down yesterday. And what a different reality they are arriving home to. Instead of being greeted by loved ones and family, they're being met with Border Force police and Defence Force personnel. Today we've seen dozens, from babes in arms to more elderly people in wheelchairs, file onto those buses, which have been kept around half full so as to allow as much social distancing as possible. From there, of course, they're going to hotels where they'll spend 14 days and face tough on-the-spot fines of $1,000 if they breach quarantine rules.
Strange to come back like this and not see friends and family. But, yeah, in another way, it felt like wider family, you know, we're all Aussies in this together.
It's pretty grim, to be honest. I'm just hoping they put us somewhere nice, but I understand that it's essential, I guess. Like, I understand why they're doing it.
Mark, police have been urging friends and family not to come to the airport to greet their loved ones, but that didn't stop one man this morning who was desperate to see his sister and his nephew. They met across the barrier for that reunion, but of course were forced to keep that 1.5 metre distance between them.
Definitely, I would like to hug them, but I think at the moment it's impossible to hug them.
Now, around 20,000 arrivals are expected here at Sydney Airport over the next week. Anyone displaying symptoms of the coronavirus will be forced into what's called a deeper form of quarantine, but certainly a very long journey home for these Australians, Mark.
OK, Lizzie, thank you for that. Well, Western Australia's Rottnest Island will today become a quarantine zone for more than 200 Australians from the Vasco da Gama cruise ship. Medical and security staff will be keeping close watch to ensure no one brings COVID-19 to the mainland. For more on this, we are now joined by reporter Cayman Gock. Cayman, what is the latest there?
Well, Mark, the cruise ship nightmare continues today here in WA as the operation to remove all Australians from the Vasco da Gama begins. From 9 a.m. local time, 200 West Australians will be escorted off the cruise ship onto ferries and they'll head to Rottnest Island to spend 14 days in quarantine. There's also 600 interstate Australians on board that cruise ship. Later today, they'll get buses, they'll head to the Duxton Hotel in the Perth CBD where they'll spend their 14 days in quarantine. Now, police will be... That hotel will be under police guard to ensure no one breaches their quarantine. After a fortnight there, they'll then get their flights back to their home states and spend a further 14 days in isolation. Now, it's important to note there has been no reported symptoms or cases of COVID-19 on the Vasco da Gama, but these are precautionary measures the state government is taking. One of the biggest concerns in WA right now is the Artania cruise ship, which has no Australians on board but has since had 29 positive cases of COVID-19. Initially, the Premier assured West Australians that no one on that cruise ship would be getting off, but the Commonwealth has since forced his hand and now 29 foreigners are in WA hospital beds, which has locals on edge. The Premier himself has described the Artania cruise ship as the Achilles heel in the plan to stop the spread of the virus in WA. Mark?
Cayman Gock, thank you. Well, Tasmania has recorded its first coronavirus death, bringing the national toll to 17. The woman, aged in her 80s, died in a hospital in Burnie this morning. The latest fatality comes as the state's premier said tough new social distancing rules set to come into effect at midnight will be enforced. Well, schools and childcare centres across South Australia's Barossa Valley are closed today after a cluster of cases were diagnosed across the region. The cluster has been linked to two tourist groups from the US and Switzerland. Health officials say the closures are needed to try and get on top of the number of cases being diagnosed across the state.